Hello everyone, Dr. Rawls here. What's a Herxheimer and what do you do about it? The classic definition of a Herxheimer is inflammation and pain and discomfort caused by bacterial die-off. In other words, you take an antibiotic, it kills the bacteria, it breaks it apart, and these particles flood through your system, activating your immune system, causing inflammation, and it just makes you feel terrible all over. So it generally occurs after you started some kind of therapy. That can be anything that kills microbes. Antibiotics tend to cause the most intense die-off, but you also can find it with herbs or virtually anything that is killing microbes. But I don't think the definition is quite complete. And the reason I say that is because so many of the microbes that we're talking about here are intracellular. They live inside cells. So I think of it more as an intensification of the tug of war that's happening between the microbes and the immune system. So classically, only certain kinds of microbes cause true Herxheimer reactions. Borrelia, the one associated with Lyme disease, is one of those. But there are others, but there are many that don't. And I still think that we're getting a reaction in those situations also. So what's happening with Lyme and fibromyalgia and all of these things that are likely associated with these intercellular or stealth microbes is that the microbes are manipulating the immune system to generate inflammation, which breaks down tissues and allows them to have resources. So the microbes are actually in very low concentrations, often confined just to insides of cells. So when we add on a therapy that starts putting pressure on those microbes, we're not only having some die-off, but we're also intensifying that reaction, that tug of war between the microbes and the immune system. So to get over it, to solve the problem of Herxheimer reaction, part of it is riding it out. And sometimes that involves decreasing the therapy so you decrease the intensity of the reaction. I found, though, that herbs in general are going to cause less in the way of Herxheimers than antibiotics because the die-off is less intense. Also, your antibiotics are affecting microbes in the gut and you're having die-off there, which can intensify the Herxheimer reaction. So herbs are going to have less tendency to do that. Herbs have anti-inflammatory properties. A lot of herbs can help clear the immune system. There are various different herbs that we use from time to time that help clear some of that from the immune system. So clearing the immune system, reducing inflammation, sometimes reducing the intensity of the therapy, and taking the time to eat well, making sure you're getting plenty of rest, because if you're not sleeping, then Herxheimer reactions are going to be much, much more intense. So doing things to help promote that healing capacity of your body is going to help reduce the intensity of the Herxheimer. If you'd like to know more information about these kinds of topics, please check out my website, rawlsmd.com. You'll find information about Herxheimer reactions and a lot of other things. Take the time to sign up for our newsletter to keep this information coming to you regularly. Hey, thanks for watching. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Take the time to leave comments, ask me questions, let me know about other things that you would like to hear about. Thank you.